My government has also begun the process of recognizing heroes and heroines of the first women of Kenya. In this regard, on 25 May 2021, I unveiled the statue and monument of Mwianyang in Harare. During the opening of the Bulawayo Arts Festival and the commemorations of Bulawayo Day, I also had occasion to revisit the adversities and difficulties experienced by our people in Matabele under the brutal settler colonialists. I applaud the creative cultural industries for their quest to tell the stories of all the heroes and heroines of our country. This collective narrative acknowledges that the war of resistance and liberation was fought throughout the entire country, Zimbabwe. This recognition of our heroes and heroines will therefore extend to the likes of General Mchana Kumalo, who commanded the Mbizo Regiment under King Dumbuya, that defeated Allan Mbusu Jatro at the Battle of Pumpu on 10 December 1893, which can never, ever forget and ignore. So we must recognize the commander of that battle, Kumalo. People like Rubeko, Sekuka, Gumbi, Chamiluka, Mukwati, Queen Rose Kay, Shinengun, Mashamombe, Ganda and Joker, Shuashira, Mucheterwa, Chingaira Makoni, Makoni, and many, many others are heroes, must always remember.